Today's project is going to help me get better organized with all my PPE, my personal safety equipment, which usually looks like this. Okay, I envisioned this kind of rack and storage shelf that's going to hold all my helmets, jackets, and accessories. And it's super useful and super simple. I'm going to be using the Millermatic 211 for this project. The basic material list is going to be a piece of 12 inch by 24 inch 18 gauge steel. You could use 16 gauge, which would make it a little bit harder to cut with hand tools, or you could even use 20 gauge. I don't think I would go any lighter than 20 gauge, but the 18 gauge is what I'm going to be using. Also, I bought three pieces of 48 inch quarter inch round stock. All this stuff you can pretty much get from any of your big box home improvement store or your local hardware store. So here I'm going to be making a 4-inch cut. So it's going to be 4 inches by 24 inches. And then I'm going to cut 2 inches off this remaining piece, which obviously will be 8 inches. That's how you cut it. So I'm going to take those two pieces that I just cut. I'm going to take the long piece and weld it to the shorter, wider piece. And it's going to be welded in the center. So basically it's going to be an inch over on each side and an inch up. So you're going to basically have 3 inches and then 1 inch. Okay, so it'll look like that when we're done. Or if you're looking at it from the other side, it'll look like that. So I've got my Millermatic 211 in the auto set mode set for 18 gauge. We're just going to do some spot welds on here, really, to hold this in. This doesn't have to be welded fully. And remember, read and follow all labels and your owner's manuals. I'm going to get lined up on one corner. I'll hit that corner first. Line up my middle. And my other side. With it tacked into position, I'm going to take some squares. Because this is nice light material, I'll be able to adjust it so that the whole thing is at 90 degrees. I'm going to take some of these little magnetic squares. I'm going to add a few more tacks to the back and also a couple on the front side. Your next step is take a piece of your round stock, and we're basically going to make a little frame that goes around here. So I'm gonna mark I'm gonna mark 8 inches, and then make another mark at 31. Okay, so as I make those bends, it is going to gain a little bit of length. So I know this back piece is 24 inches. My ultimate goal is to land the two ends somewhere in the middle or closer to the outside edge. I want it to overlap this base a little bit. So I want to come out 8 inches. I want to make this bend here, and I want it to come back 8 inches, and we're going to weld it to this back piece. So I'm going to take that piece we just bent, and we're going to fit it up here and probably have to do a couple of trim cuts. And again, my object was to overlap these bars here so that they're towards the outer side or at least the middle, and we're pretty close. And I'm gonna take my square. So I'm gonna have to mark. Now we'll make our trim cuts. I'm gonna use a cutoff wheel, but you could use a sawzall or a bandsaw or even a hacksaw. And make sure you deburr the edges. So your bends might not be exactly the same as mine. So mine's ending up to being about 1/4 inch from the end on each side and 3/4 inches from the top. Now that I've got my marks where my bar is going to be welded to, I'm actually going to drill 2 3/16 holes there. And I'm going to use those to plug weld from the back side. I'm also going to put a couple welds on the outside edge of that 1/4 round stock as well. Our next step is going to be determining how tall our 3 support bars are going to be. We're going to have to weld 3 support bars, one on each corner and one in the middle. So when this is, after this is welded to the back side, you know, it'll look something like that. Looks like about 2 1/8. So I'm going to cut 3 pieces, 2 1/8 off of this drop-off piece. So this is with everything in position. I marked the center of our bent 1/4 inch bar, and I also marked the center of the base, and I put one of our standoffs there and one on each corner. So I'm gonna tack those in first, and then I can just put these at their final position. I did also jump the auto set on the machine up to the 16 gauge setting because of the 1/4 inch, and the 18 gauge is kind of a happy medium. And this is where I'm gonna hit the 2 outside edges of the 1/4 inch and plug weld it from behind. You also might want to just round your edges here on the corners so you don't catch yourself when you're reaching in this thing. Alright, so what that did is it stiffened this whole thing up, because ultimately I'm going to drill 2 holes in here and attach it to the side of my building. Now I've got a metal sided building, so I can put those holes anywhere. But if you've got just a standard wood structure, you might want to hit the studs. So you may want to put those at 16 inch centers, or you know, whatever, to whatever application you got going on. So, but this really made that firm and rigid. Take another piece of your 1/4 inch round stock and cut it in half. These were 48 inches total. So at 24, make your mark. Also, make a mark at 4 inches off of each end, because we're going to heat that up and bend it. Wow, it's like a CNC machine did it. All right, so our last step with our 1/4 inch round stock is we need 2 more 4 inch pieces cut off of here. That's gonna give us 4 hooks total. Now take those two pieces that you just cut, those 4 inches, and we're gonna weld those to our main piece here at between 3 and 3.5 inches. I'm making a mark at 3.25. As long as you have enough room between that hook and the underside of this is all I'm worried about. And again, the neat thing about this quarter inch stuff is
you can always bend it if it's not in the exact position you want it.
So this is what it's gonna kind of look like in the end. We're gonna take those hangers you made, make a mark at 6.5 and 17.5, which is gonna center them, and weld them to this 1 inch lip. That's really gonna be for those of you who have smooth walls in your shop. I have ribbed steel walls, so I'm gonna actually take mine and weld them on the backside. And that's my PPE storage. I got room for my helmets and face shields, my weld jackets, gloves, weld mask too, and my welding sleeves, even my safety glasses. Now all I gotta do is paint it blue.